Why did the wrongs
move forward as a country? We need to know
more about. We're at the early part of that process of reconciliation.
Although the NWMO has been in business now for over 15 years, we're still in that process of learning. And one of the things that's important for us is to learn differences between a corporate culture and an indigenous culture and how we can interweave those two things together so that our project is implemented in the best way possible. We're at the early part of that process of reconciliation.
So this now has become just a way of doing business. I think NWMO has grown tremendously, not only within the organization, but I think that they're very quick also to share that with the other partners that are involved with the project, and they're leading that work.
The work we've done to date at the NWMO over the past 10 years to get us where we are today to have a reconciliation statement makes me very proud to be an employee at the NWMO, to be part of that change of how we're going to work with Indigenous communities and non-Indigenous communities. It's equally as important that we're all on this path together. It's been really rewarding and an honor and a privilege to be part of.
Early on at the NWMO, we had an Aboriginal policy which established how we would work in Aboriginal communities, if you will, recognizing legal rights and the responsibility for consultation and mitigation, if you will. We then moved on to an Indigenous knowledge policy, which described how we would take Indigenous knowledge, how we would understand that, and how we would interweave it into our program. And I think our next step now is the reconciliation statement, leading to strategies that will help better inform us on how to implement this project in the most beneficial way and in the best way possible for all Canadians.